Welcome to my kitchen this time. When you think about the Super Bowl, you think about nachos, wings, and chili. Well, I've got my own spin on a chili. It's a chicken chili, and here it is. So you take a pound of boneless, skinless chicken breasts, and you basically cut those right into bite-sized chunks. So on a medium to large skillet, just a little bit of olive oil. And then on a medium to medium-high heat, you're going to basically just cook that chicken in a skillet. So while the chicken is cooking, we're going to come back over and cut up our veggies. And our garlic, we're going to toss the garlic in first. So let's do that. That's going to go in with the chicken. And just large chunks, not too small. Same thing with the onions, just a rough chop. And all this is going to go into the chicken. Right, so while that chicken is cooking and the veggies, we're going to open all these cans. We have a big tomato soup. This is a family size. Corn, keep the juice for the corn. Pinto bean, and we have a black bean and a red kidney bean. Again, strain. All right, now we're ready to put everything basically into the crock pot. What I do is take the veggies and the chicken that have been cooking for about 10 minutes. You see right here, everything's cooked. Veggies are just a little bit softened. And we're going to add our can of tomato soup, chili seasoning packet. And it can be anything. Hot, I got just regular. Put the whole packet in there. Corn with the juice from the can. Beans that we drained, the pinto, the kidney, and the black beans. And the secret ingredient to this, I think, is the brown sugar. I was down in Martha's Vineyard and had some great chili there, and I had tasted a hint of sweetness, and I said, "What is that?" And they said, "Brown sugar, but don't tell anybody." So of course I tell everybody. I usually put a quarter of a cup. If you like a little sweeter, you could put half a cup. And you just, that's it. You're going to put the cover on this for, it really, it's all cooked. You just have to heat it through. So put it on low for an hour before your guests get there and it'll be ready. After an hour, it's ready to serve. And you can top it with either some grated cheese or some corn chips. And so there you have it, my spin on chicken chili with a Martha's Vineyard twist. Go Pats!